Show some style. True light will cleanse you. Your poisonous bite is useless on me. Blood of a true defender of this land will protect me. I know. It hurts, doesn't it? Freewood prevails! Try something else. True light will cleanse you. Your poisonous bite is useless on me. Close your eyes! This is gonna hurt. I'll pin you down! Some style. Fight like a man. I know. It hurts, doesn't it? Why does simple light burn you so much? Close your eyes! This is gonna hurt. We are the guardian of justice. Priwen shall prevail.
You can't accept the fact we're not enemies, can you?
We always have been, and we always will be. Of all the evils that threaten mankind, your kind are the worst.
I'm not saying we could be friends, you and I. But perhaps we could collaborate to put an end to this epidemic.
Never! We are Priwen. We do not negotiate. We do not compromise.
There is no way you'll ever let me be, McCollum. You'll always hunt me down, won't you?
There is no escape, Leech. Kill me now. For there is no way you can sway me to your ideals.
That's where you're mistaken.
What do you mean?
I'll make you a vampire. I'll make you one of us.
No! Kill me!
You're about to be hunted, just like me.
No! No!
When I kissed goodbye, I had no idea what I was doing. But now I do. Consider this my kiss of Judas.
Thank you. So Priwen never left Doris's theatre after they invaded. They must be holding Edgar here in their new headquarters. It's locked. I cannot enter. Convenient time.
Thank you.
It's locked. Doris Fletcher was about to become a disaster. I'm getting close to having all the evidence. It's locked, all right. It's locked. It's locked. It's locked, all right. It's locked. I should find the key to that box. It's locked, all right. Blood of a pure heart, garlic, blood of a king. I don't understand. Perhaps this is what McCullum drank.
Edgar.
I had better keep that in mind.
Edgar, can you hear me?
Jonathan, is it really you?
Easy. Easy. Save your strength. I'm getting you out of here.
Don't try to spare me. As a physician, I know all too well when it's too late. Punctured lung, broken ribs, and internal bleeding. An accurate diagnosis, wouldn't you say?
Edgar, what happened?
They wanted me to confess. Beat me black and blue.
Geoffrey McCullum ambushed me at the Pembroke Hospital. He was
I never imagined that self-righteous fanatic would...
I put him in a somewhat...
Really? Are you sure that was the wisest course of action?
Time will tell. The most intriguing part of his accusation was that you and I were the pawns of some ancient vampire.
William Marshall.
I think you're hiding something, Edgar.
What do you mean?
William Marshall, for example.
Jonathan, I cannot say I'm ready for another round of questions.
While investigating the epidemic, I read some of McCullum's findings.
I have nothing to hide, Jonathan.
Doris Fletcher visited her mother at the Pembroke Hospital. That's how she first got infected.
I know nothing about that. Miss Fletcher once came to visit the sick. That is all I know.
No, Edgar.
What does this sad story have to do with us?
Doris and Harriet shared more than a hidden family bond. They were the embodiment of the epidemic and are linked to the Pembroke Hospital. Come on, Edgar, this is no coincidence.
I swear, I'm at a complete loss. All I did was administer vampire blood to cure old Harriet. There was no evil plan, no diabolical plot.
You did what?
I tested the regenerating and healing properties of vampire blood on Harriet Jones. My only intention was to find the cure for influenza, I swear.
Whose blood did you use? William Marshall's? Mine?
Lady Ashbury's. While transfusing her with human blood, humanely appeasing her hunger, I also kept samples of her blood for my research.
You used her blood on Harriet Jones? My God, Edgar, that's unethical. You betrayed two of your patients at the same time.
How dare you judge me? Must I name the alarming list of your victims?
We are both deceivers. But at least I know I'm a monster.
You have worked beside me. You saw what I'm doing at Pembroke Hospital. Jonathan, you know I'm not an evil soul. Just another victim of this tragedy.
Yes, your death is imminent, Dr. Swansea. But I swear, it will be quick.
I already told you to call me Edgar. Am I no longer your friend?
I believe you never have been, sir. You have lied to me at every step and betrayed the trust of a woman I cherish.
You and the lady? Really? Well, I should have seen it coming, I suppose. May I add that I welcome this? The biting, I mean.
You have your wish.
Is it going to hurt? I always wondered if you... Ah!